guys, this is MBDC back with another video for you here today. And today we're talking about Arrow season 1. And I know some of you are like, what? We're in season 7. Why are you talking about season 1, bro? Come on, bro. You behind the times, bro. I get it. Season 7 is going on, but we are in December, January 2019, end of the year-ish, and as you guys know who watch DC TV, they're on their mid-season finale break. So, figured, why not? New channel. There's some people out there who are just getting into the Arrowverse, and I feel like, maybe this review might be helpful for them. I got the idea because my wife started getting into the Arrowverse, and I actually watched season 1 again. I haven't watched it in a long time, but I watched it again. I'm like, man, it's good. Like, this is why I started watching the Arrowverse. Man, season 1 was good. So, for those of you who don't know, Arrow is a show about a vigilante named Oliver Queen. He was a party billionaire, playboy, trust fund brat. He went on a cruise with his dad and his girlfriend's sister. Yeah, playboy, bad guy. Boat gets in a storm. They get shipwrecked. His dad ends up killing himself and asks Oliver to right his wrongs. He gives him this book with a list of names. Oliver has no idea at the time what these names mean or what his dad's wrongs are at this time. So he gets on this island. He tries to survive. He runs into a guy named Yao Fei. Yao Fei, him get captured. He escapes, and Yao Fei tells him to find the crash plane. Inside the crash plane, we meet Slade Wilson. As you guys know, it's Deathstroke. So, not gonna get too in depth on it or whatever, but basically, him and Slade trying to find a way off the island. He's still trying to save Yao Fei because Yao Fei had his back. Yao Fei gets captured. He's helping out Friars. A mercenary gets paid to have Yao Fei say he's going to take down an airplane. And it's this whole conspiracy trying to destabilize the Chinese government. The reason why Yao Fei is doing this, not to betray Oliver, but to they have his daughter captured, Shadow. Shadow plays a big part in the reason why Slade becomes a villain in the next season, in season 2, but we'll get to that in a season 2 review. Basically, then Oliver finds his, in present day, Oliver makes it home. He decides, you know what, I'm going to be the Arrow. I'm going to go in one of my old dad's, one of the buildings he owned, one of the steelworks or something like that, build a little cave and become, he didn't call himself anything. They start calling him the Vigilante, the Hood, in season 1. He was the Hood. He wasn't named Green Arrow or anything like that in season 1. He was just the Hood. Basically, he went around stopping these people on that book that his dad gave him with the list of names. That list of names had billionaires, people stealing money from people. He was going around stopping these people. Then he started fighting petty crime and things like that. He got Diggle involved in season 1, which was his bodyguard and driver. And then eventually he got Felicity Smoke, IT girl from Queen Consolidated, to help out in season 1. And she became a member of the team. But again, don't want to get too in depth. I know a lot of you guys probably already seen season 1. If you have not seen season 1, you need to go watch it. Season 1 is awesome. It kicks everything off. It basically just kind of get you a little taste of Oliver and get you a little taste of his world with the flashbacks. They do the 5 year ago flashbacks and what happened to Leon Yu and present day and how he's trying to right his father's wrongs by going through the book and some of the choices he has to make as a vigilante. Sometimes or it blurs that line between, is it right or is it wrong? Is he a murderer? Is he a vigilante? Is he a hero? Like, where is he at? He has his own self-doubts, but it is a good season, which ends in a big conspiracy that his mom is involved in, which you find out the Queen's Gambit, the ship that him and his dad was on, that got him stranded on the island. You find out the Queen's Gambit was sunk by Malcolm Merlyn, Tommy, his best friend, his dad. And then you find out his mom's involved. Well, his dad was involved, but his mom's involved. So it's all kinds of crazy. Malcolm Merlyn ends up being the Dark Archer, which is the main villain for season 1. So there's always like these little bads and one big bad, which got the Dark Archer being the big bad of this season, which his master plan is the Undertaking. The Undertaking, he wants to blow up the Glades or level the Glades with the earthquake machine. The Glades being the bad part of town, the rundown, low income part of town. He wants to level that with an earthquake machine and rebuild the Glades. So it's Malcolm Merlyn's plan. He's been working on for a long time. His dad was involved. His dad tried to get out, which got him killed in the first place. And then his mom got involved. So, and then you see Oliver trying to struggle with finding out his mom's involved and stop Malcolm and all that kinds of stuff. So, again, great season. I would have to give, I'm giving ratings. I haven't decided whether I'm giving ratings on this channel here or not. But if I had to give it a rating, man, it's an A+. Season one was awesome. The fight choreography was really good. The way they shot it was really good. Costume design good. Script good. I thought Oliver, especially now that we're in season seven, going back to season one, Oliver's a little stiff, I feel like, or Stephen Amell's a little stiff saying some of his lines, but he just came back from an island trying to get himself reacclimated to the real world. I guess that you can kind of chuck it up to that. But again, great show. Loved it. Hope you guys enjoyed too. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. Stay tuned for my next video. I will definitely catch you guys in the next one. This is MBDC. Peace. What'd you think about Arrow season one? Was it good? Did you like it?
Yes, I loved it. My favorite character so far in the series has to be Felicity. She's smart. She loves tech. And then there's...
Felicity. Well, I'm going to stop right there. Felicity. Whoa.
She's the best.